I'm going to do it to you now that Jerry's going to get us started on. So, a little bit of Sister Kate, and we'll take it slow and easy, all wrapped up in one. Take two.
Shock, she my love, Sister Kate. She makes a chicken like jelly on a plate. Oh, Mama says just all night. She said, why the boys treat kids so right?
Dreamed I was among the ones who put him out to death. I woke in anguish, so long and terrified. I put my fingers against the glass, hung down my head and cried, hung down my head and cried.
Gonna do a song now that you can participate in. During the song I yell out hurrah, because this is an old hymn. And when I yell hurrah, you yell it back at me and all that stuff. Okay. It's a very subtle song.
Don't cry, lady.
Play this song on a ukulele, and that's how I learned it. And part of the folk tradition is it's got to be passed down from one person to the next. So in the folk tradition, we pass it along to you now.
Coney Island, washboard, hill and flag. Drag it to right through.
to the beach. Me and my Rhonda, surfboard and six pack on my mattress Honda. Everybody turned on by the wonderful way I say the words. Yeah. We got to the beach, me and my Rhonda. She was dressed in her madness bikini now. She was going on her madness surfboard out 460 miles out into the ocean. And I called out to her, I said, Rhonda, honey.
Rhonda, baby.
I always called her that because that was her name. She liked me to call her that. I said, Rhonda.
Rhonda,
do you know you can't swim? Don't you think you ought to take off my 40-pound high school ring? It's hanging down there between your...
Between your... between your...
two-piece bathing suit. But you never answered me. The sun was setting and the sea was surging. Rhonda was sinking now. I'll never forget, honey. I'll never forget those dying words she said to me. Tell me about it, baby.
Thank you.
all woke up again about 10:30. Old coke had me on again. Cocaine all around my brain. Woke up again about 4:45. Lord, I was both dead and alive. All around my brain. Come here, beer. Come on and run now. Coke, I'm sitting on the sun. Cocaine. All around my brain. You take Nancy, I'll take Sue. Ain't no difference between the two. Oh, cocaine. All around my brain. Coats for horses, ain't for men. Tell me gonna kill me, but they won't tell me when. Cocaine around my brain. Come here, honey. Come on and run now. Oh, coke, got me sitting on the sun. Cocaine all around my brain.
Okay. Wow. Okay. Good, good. I guess we didn't run out of wine yet. You hear from the sound. I explained a little bit about what we're doing here. Mainly, we're interested in catching a grizzly bear, and we decided in order to catch the grizzly bear, we had to set the stage, because those grizzly bears are hard to get out of the woods, you know. And you gotta sort of edge them on out easy. Is everybody there? I don't even know if there's any grizzly bears on that side. Vinny, you there?
I ain't seen no grizzly bears.
Peter, are the grizzly bears behind you? Okay, how about the drums? You know, no worries back there. All right. Here we go. Now I know we're all frightened of grizzly bears, dig? When we're little, we have grizzly bears that live in our closet. Grizzly bears that hide underneath the bed. Well, this cat was so paranoid about grizzly bears, he had little teeny tiny grizzly bears that hid behind the bristles on his toothbrush. He had smaller grizzly bears even that hid under the hairs on grandmother's face that you didn't talk about. And all those grizzly bears, they just growl all over the place. And he laying there in bed and he hiding under the pillows. He hiding under covers and pull them way up top, but the grizzly bear couldn't get him. He look out just for me, see any grizzly bear there. And what you go and set the foot of his bed. Ain't his daddy. Ain't his mama. He's a grizzly bear. He say, rawr! Say, rawr! Say, rawr! Decided he could not be scared of grizzly bears all his life. He'd have to go out and find either a place to hide from those grizzly bears, or he'd have to meet that grizzly bear on his own home territory and do him harm. So he put a little gun, a little knife in his pocket, and he went trailing out. He got on his bicycle, he rode all the way to California. He said, maybe if I join myself up with a motorcycle gang, that grizzly bear will be frightened to death of the motorcycle cats, and he won't come around and bother me. So he went looking for the biggest, baddest, worstest, most terrible, mean, and nefarious motorcycle gang in the world. That's what he found. That was their name. They had it on the back of their black leather jackets and brass studs, and they kept two brass stud makers in business just making the studs to make that name in the back of their jackets. He walked up to the leader. He said, hello, leader. I won't join up with your gang so that grizzly bear can't get a hold of me and eat me and do all terrible things to my body. He said, sure, you can join us, kid. You just gotta fight Teeny Tiny over there. He looked over and Teeny Tiny was the meanest of them all. He weighed 714 pounds. He had a mini bike with a jet engine under it. A lot of pickup on that bike, man. He could go in so fast, so far, he had to wear cast iron underwear. In case he wanted to stop, he just slid off the back of the bike and let sparks fly three or four counties. Well, he looked over that grizzly bear coming down the hill on a Honda 50, and he looked a Teeny Tiny, and he decided on the grizzly bear. The grizzly bear decided on all of them. He came roaring in, and he said, rah! Well, there were motorcycle cats flying every direction, and that old grizzly bear, he right out on their tail. This cat, he ran inside a church. He figured a lot of people hide in a church. Why shouldn't he? He was hiding under a pew, and this cat came walking up to him in a Zorro suit. He was all beautiful, hanging down black then. He said, can I help you? And the cat said, I'm afraid of the grizzly bear. The cat said to him, you don't have to be afraid of nothing in here. You just join on our society, and we'll take care of all your needs. Sign on a dotted line, become part of us, and you can hide here forever. Just then, while he was talking, the grizzly bear came in the back of the church. His cat looked up. His preacher-type cat, he saw that grizzly bear. I tell you, folks, he ran over 4 baptismal fonts, 16 silver candlesticks, 4 choir boys, and an associate pastor on the way out the back door. He showed enough, didn't the grizzly bear say, ah! He hadn't gone too far when he decided that wasn't the way he could operate at all. He had to go face that grizzly bear. He hiked his little body down to Louisiana. He was looking all around for that grizzly bear. He went up a tall mountain looking for the grizzly bear. He kept slipping and sliding up that mountain. He got to the top and there was this great big tree. Yeah, you know who's behind that tree, don't you? Yeah, one Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, baby. Just then, up from behind the tree came the grizzly bear, and he was 47 feet tall. He had yellow teeth, because he never brushed them. He had red eyes, because you know what he was doing behind that tree, right? He had very hip there. Right? He had snaggly, faggly hair, because he never combed it. He looked sort of like a football player going out of the shower. Yeah. He looked down at his cat, he said, you ready for this now? Sarah! Well, the cat couldn't have none of that. He had to get out of there. He had to get away from that bear. So he pulled his portable skateboard out of the back of his pocket. He went slipping, sliding down the hill. He was going 412 miles an hour down that hill now. And going past Maserati. He was going past Yamaha. He was touring down that hill. And went past that old bear in his Honda 50. Went the bear. He failed to negotiate a very dangerous curve, and he crashed through the front door of his big old White House. Inside that house, there was a meeting of the let's keep everything exactly the way it always has been, the way our grandpappies built it, with a sweat of their brow and the muscle of their arm society. They were sitting around there painting each other red, white, and blue. They were grooving on a mother. They had a mother stuffed in the closet. And they were just hanging there, and they were grooving on it. They were eating apple pie. And then they ran out of apple pie, but the cat came. He walked through the door and said, I got the pie here from Mother. What do I do with him? And they say, just put him up against the wall there, Mother Trucker. Yeah, and he did. And just at that point, the bear came through the door. I tell you, folks, there was apple pies. There was Mother's. There was America Love It or Leave It stickers. There were 47,000 red, white, and blue people heading out every window, every door. All the bear did was say, rah! Stand round! Stand round! Oh, no.
He got a little further down the hill, and he met a bunch of freaks. They were all sitting around. They were beautiful cats. They had hair way down to their whatever, and they're all wearing beads, and they're sitting around a big circle. They're passing around this funny little pipe and breathing deep and kind of funny and just sort of thing. They were saying things like, oh, wow. They all say, oh, wow. They said that for 14 days. Oh, wow. Just then the leader of the group stood up. He was the most articulate cat they ever found in here. Flunked out of 4 Ivy League colleges, dropped out of 3 state universities, and about to liberate the local nursery school. He was standing there looking around when a bear came through the back door. Being as articulate as he was, he looked up and he said, oh, wow, that's heavy. And the bear, he said, rah. I said, he said, rah! I said, he said, rah! Jumping out the door, their eyes were looking like the road maps to Red China. They're running down the road so fast, so furious. Hair and cigarette papers flying in the air, and bottles of patchouli tripping over there. He was doing all kinds of weird things there. The cat, he finally had enough, so he saved himself. He said, whoa! He said, whoa, baby, I can't run anymore. I run away from this bed too long already. I can't run away from this bed anymore. So he reached in his back pocket. And there was the pearl-handled Freudian pistol that his grandpappy had given him in case he ever met up with a situation just like this. He reached out with that pearl-handled pistol. He pointed at the bear, and the gun said, ka-chow. And the bear said, oh, let me fall down. And he started walking towards that old bear. He walked right up to that bear, and he reached in the back of his pocket, and he pulled out a pearl-handled Freudian knife that his grandmammy had given him just in case he ever walked into a situation just like this. Walked up to that bear and he started cutting along the dotted lines. Yeah. He started peeling back all that bear fur. He peeled it all back. He wanted to see what it was he'd been scared of all his life. The thing that had frightened him to death. Frightened me to death. Frightened everybody to death. He peeled it back, Lord God, right in the middle of that bear. There was a full color, full size portrait. Spiro T. Agony. He said, rah! Do one more song, and then we're gonna all put on the lights and carry out the dead bodies. See who made it and who didn't do the whole thing. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan. You know that Pharaoh's army got drowned. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. One of these days. Don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. One of these days, about 12 noon, a new world's coming, Lord can't come too soon. You know the Pharaoh's army got to run out there. I said, oh, Mary, don't hold your weep. Oh, oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan. You know the Pharaoh's army got to run out there. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. Come along, honey, just walk with me. I'll give you my loving, Lord, I'll set you free. You know the Pharaoh's army got drowned. Lord, oh, Mary, Mary, don't you weep.
Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan.
Singing a brand new song. I know the Pharaoh's army got drowned. Lord, oh Mary, don't you weep. Come on now.
Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan. Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you moan. You know the Pharaoh's army got drowned.
Oh Mary, don't you weep. I said, oh, thank you, you've been a great audience.